Yes, my voice is audible.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Okay, one minute, ma. Again, I will share the screen. Now, PPT is visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma. Yes. Now, in once you determine so the magnet, okay, 1 minute. Now, once you determine the magnitude of forces of what are the forces which are acting on the link 6, that is Fi6 and F16, then I will go for transmit the forces to each part of the mechanism. Now see, we know that the Fi6, we know that Fi6 how much? 275 newton. The Fi6 is equal to what? F65. That is equal to F45. The magnitude is same, but act in opposite direction. See that line of action of Fi6 are the Fi6 forces acting towards the slider. Now if you go for take the link 5, Fi6 is equal to F65, but acting at the hinges are same. It hinges F only, turning pair only, but acting if you want to make it equilibrium of that, then you go for apply. The force should be in opposite in nature, magnitude is same, acting along the same line of action, right? Now again, the link 5 is subjected to only two forces. Again, if you want to make it equilibrium, F65 is equal to F56, right? That is equal to F56 is equal to F65, that is equal to F45. Now the link 5 is subjected to only two forces. The magnitude is same, but act in what? Opposite direction, right? Next, transmit this force from hinge C here, another link here, 3. On the link 3 is also separated to, sorry, not link 3. 5 is connected to what? Which link here? 4. Now 5 is connected to link 4. Now come to here, right? Now link 4 is subjected to how many forces? At hinge D, F14 is there. We don't know the magnitude and direction. And at link, at hinge C, it is F34. At hinge E, it is F54. But we know the magnitude of F54, right? That is equal to F45. F545 is equal to F55. F54, we know the magnitude. And also, we know the direction. This is acting at the link 5, it is acting towards here. At hinge E, at the link 4, it is acting away from here. It's opposite to here, right? We know this, the magnitude and direction of this force. We know that first tick mark shows magnitude, second tick mark shows direction. We know the Fi4 at the hinge E, what is magnitude is acting here? 257.5 newton, and direction is towards the point E from link 5 to link 4, right? After that, now at hinge C, see that hinge C, that link 4 is connected to link 3 at hinge C. The link 3 is subject to how many forces? Only two forces, F23 and F43. Those two forces are, again, if you make it equilibrium, when a body is subject to two forces, those two forces should be in equal in magnitude, act in opposite direction, and acting along the same line of action. Now the F34, we don't know the magnitude, we don't know the direction also, but what we know, that we know the line of action of F34. The line of action of F34 is parallel to link 3 only, right? That is, we draw a line here parallel to, see that we draw a line here parallel to link 3, but we don't know the direction. It's acting towards the link 4, away from the link 4. How do you know that? By drawing a force polygon of link 4, then only you can get the magnitude and direction of F34. At the same time, at hinge D here, See that the link 4 is connected to link 1 and link 4 at hinge D. Right? What is the force act here? F14. Again, we don't know the magnitude and direction. Now, tell me the link 4 is subject to how many forces? One is F54, second one is F34, third one is F14. Now, the link 4 is subject to how many forces? Three forces. If I want to make it equilibrium, then all the three forces should be meet at a point. That point is called as a point of concurrency. Now, how do you get point of concurrency? We know the magnitude and direction of link F54, right? Now, extend that line. Again, we know the line of action of F34. Extend that line. Those two lines meet at a point. That point is called as a point of concurrency. Now, from the point O, join that point O to D. That gives a line of action of F14, right? Now, if you want, this is F14 and F34, the magnitude and directions are unknown. Then how do you determine? By drawing a force polygon of the link 4. Again, by taking a same scale. What is the scale here? Force polygon, 50 Newton is equal to 1 centimeter, right? Now, which is the known magnitude here? F54, you know that, right? Now take any one point, draw a line which is parallel to the line of action of F54. Now that point, from the starting point, we'll call it as L, then draw a line which is parallel to the line of action of F54. What is the length of the line? What is F54 here? 275 Newton. What is the 275 when you go for convert into scale? 275 Newton divided by 50, we will get 5.5 centimeter. Draw a line which is parallel to line of action F54. On that line, measure 5.5 centimeter. Now we'll get the point M. The length of the line LM shows the magnitude of vector force vector 54. And what is the direction here? Arrow mark here. See that here. What is the arrow mark here? It is upward, right? Now, once you get point M, again, you'll go for in what direction here? We'll go for take the first polygon. If you draw, either go for counterclockwise or clockwise. That is left to you. Here, I'll go for take counterclockwise. After F54, what is the next force will come here? F34. From the point M, I draw a line which is parallel to line of action of F34. From M, draw a line which is parallel to the line of action of F34. I don't know its the length of the line because magnitude is unknown. And also direction also, I don't know. You can draw M from the line here, this line of action on the both side, you should draw here. We don't know where it comes, right? Next, after F34 over, what is the next one is F14. F14 magnitude and directions are unknown, but we know the line of action of the F14, that is the OC, right? Sorry, OD line. Now draw a line which is parallel to OD, where it is from point L, because if so link 4 is subject to three forces, if you want to make it equilibrium, all the forces should meet at a point is point of concurrency. Second one, there is no resultant forces acting here, means it should be a closed force polygon. Again, from the point L, I draw a line which is parallel to the link, line of action of F14, that is OD line, right? OD line. Then the line of action of F14 and line of action of F34, they meet at a point. That point will call as a N. Next, we measure. Now we measure the line MN. Now we measure the line MN. The length of the line shows what? F34, the magnitude of F34. F34 is equal to MN. That is equal to how much you'll get? 7 centimeter. 7 into multiply the scale. 1 centimeter is equal to how many Newton here? 50 Newton. Then now we'll get 350 Newton. Then measured LN. That gives magnitude of F14. How much it is? Okay, it's not visible here. Yeah. How much it is? F14, it is equal to LM. That is how much you get? 4.8 centimeter. Then multiply into a scale. 1 centimeter is equal to 50 Newton. How much you get? 240 Newton. Those two will get magnitude. The length of the line shows a magnitude. What about direction? How do you get the direction? If you want to get the direction, where is your starting point here? Starting point is from L. Again, L to M, I know that what is the direction here? F54 here in this direction. Again, from point M, again I will come back to L. In what path will come here? M to N will go in this direction. From N to L will go in this path. Now we'll get the arrow mark shows what direction. Transmit that arrow mark into the free body diagram of the link 4. Clearly, F14 is acting downward. It is parallel to this line, right? Similarly, F34, now this is a parallel to this one. It is acting towards the link 4, right? This is how you draw the force polygon. Now, then how do you get the magnitude and direction? Now transmit again, link 4 is connected to what? Link 3, right? Link 4 is connected to what? Link 4 is connected to link 3. Now link 3 is subject to how many forces? Only two forces. Those two forces are equal. F43 is equal to F23, right? Now at the hinge C here, it is connected to link 4 only, right? What is F43 is equal to F34. What is F34? You got 350 Newton. Now that is F34 is equal to F43, that is equal to F23. That is how much here? Magnitude is 350 Newton. Now what about direction? Now F34 acting towards the link 4. F34 is equal to F43 is acting. What are these two forces are? Same magnitude, but act in opposite direction at the hinge C. That's why arrow mark comes here. Now this is link 3 subject to two forces, right? If you want to make it equilibrium, those two forces are equal in magnitude, act in opposite direction along the same line of action, right? Now after that, now transmit that again, link 3 is connected to which link? Link 2. Now link 3 is connected to link 2 at the hinge B. Again at the hinge B, we know that F23 is equal to what? F23 is equal to F32, that is equal to F4 to 350 Newton, because link 2 substituted to how many forces? Two forces parallel to each other, acting away from each other, parallel to each other and acting opposite in nature, and that produces what? A couple. Then that is also link 2 is subject to one more is a couple, that is a torque, right? Now link 2 separate to two force and a torque. When you make it equilibrium, those two force should be same magnitude. That is F23 is equal to F32. That F32 is also equal to F42. How much is 350 Newton. Those two force are parallel in nature, acting opposite in direction. Right? That produces, now what is the direction here? F23 is acting towards the link 3. That is equal to, magnitude is same, but act in opposite direction. F23 is equal to F32, act in opposite direction. Now extend this line. This is the line of action F34. Again, you will get what is F at hinge A. F12 is acting here. That is according to the force, members of the two force and a torque. Those two force should be in same magnitude. That's why you get F32 is equal to what? F12, 350 Newton. Act in opposite direction. That produces what type of couple? That produces what type of couple here? The F32 and F12, that produces a counterclockwise couple. Then I want to make it equilibrium, we need to apply a clockwise a torque T2. What is the formula for torque here? Force into perpendicular distance. Now how do you get perpendicular distance? Once you know that this is a line of action of F34, line of action of F12, take any one point on the line of action of F32, measure a 90 degree, then you draw a line that gives a perpendicular distance h. How much you'll get? The h is equal to 1.65 centimeter you'll get. Now multiply, 1 centimeter is equal to how much? 10 is to 1, right? The 1 centimeter is equal to how much? 10 centimeter. Multiply here, I think you can see here, h is equal to 1.65 centimeter. We know that 10 is to 1, right? Now 1 centimeter is equal to 10 centimeter, or it become 100 mm, multiply scale, then you'll get 165 mm, that converted into meter, 0.165 meter you'll get. Now what is the torque? Torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance, any force you can take, F32 or F12, both are same magnitude, 350 into h value, how much you got? 0.165 meter. Now you'll get the magnitude of torque what we have applied here 57.75 newton meter. But what direction these two forces are produced a couple in counterclockwise direction, that is CCW. Now we need to apply a torque in what direction here? Clockwise couple. Now this is a how we analyze the given mechanism. There's a force analysis of the given mechanism. Yes, if you have any doubt, you can ask me the doubts and clarify your doubts. Yes. Yes, Bharat GM. Bharat GM.
Sir.
Now you understood, man.
Sir.
Okay. Now, how do you represent the force convention?
Sir.
How do you represent the force convention?
Free body diagram, sir.
Force convention. I'm asking force convention. How do you represent F12? F12 stands for what? Forces acting on from which member to which member? On which member? Force transmit from which member or which link?
Force one acting on two, sir.
What it represents? Force one acting on two means what? Now force.
Force at one point. Force at point one acting on point two.
No. Force exerted by link one on link two is represented as F12. Yes, Bharat?
Sir.
Okay. Yeah, now. So, Arisha GN.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now tell me the steps involved to analyze the force analysis of a mechanism.
Procedure, sir.
Yeah, procedure. Tell
space me. Diagram first. Sir, what? First we have to try to space diagram, sir.
Okay.
At where forces acting and the reaction forces.
Okay.
Then load acting. Analyzing of load acting.
Okay.
At where point. Next free body diagram, sir.
Okay.
By using given left. Distance we have to draw free body diagram.
Okay.
Resultant force.
After drawing.
Resulting force.
What will do?
Sir.
After drawing the free body diagram, what's the next step?
Next step, our resultant force. We have to find resultant force, right?
Link you consider. For the analysis, for to determine the unknown forces acting on the link.
Unknown forces. Yes, sir. Resultant forces.
Now, before solving the problem, remember the step. This is very important. First, identify the type of mechanism. Second step.
Yes, sir.
Draw the space diagram for the mechanism by taking a suitable scale. Third one, draw the free body diagram. Means it is a diagram isolated from the main diagram. And what it shows, the nature of forces acting on that link or on the part of the mechanism. Fourth step, now consider a link which is subjected to known forces or external force. Which link is subjected to an external force? That link you have to consider. Because that force, external force, both magnitude and direction, we know that. Then draw the free body diagram for that particular link. Then we will get the remaining unknown forces which are acting on the link. Then fifth step, transmit those forces acting on the link to the remaining link which are connected to that link, right? Then finally, what is the sixth step? Then determine the input torque required to make the mechanism stabilize or equilibrium condition. These are the six steps. You should remember these six steps. Okay. I think we are almost nearer to finish this first module, not first module. In the first module, first unit. Okay, static force analysis. Okay, after once you complete this module or this chapter, again you have a unit test. Okay. Yes. Thank you, Hemant. Yeah. Shall I continue? Shall I continue the class? If you have any doubt, if you try to solve the problem, then only you get the doubts. Otherwise, you can't. The doubts will not arise for you. Okay. Yes. Next one is the principle of virtual war. Again, you can expect what are the theories for exam point of view. So, what are the theory portions you can expect from this module? First one is, first you can expect the equilibrium conditions in four in a body's members subject to two forces, three forces, or two force and a torque. There is a 4 mark, 5 mark questions. You can refer previous year question paper. Almost all the theory parts, what is there, that that conditions given, the statement as to you should write, and the condition also you should write. Apart from that, if the examiners have said they were okay, then they will go for one more theory portion is principle of virtual war. Yeah, this is what we doing here, virtual classes, right? Now, what do you mean by virtual? Virtual is nothing but is an imaginary or is an infinitesimally a small, we call it is a virtual. You can see the virtual keypad when you go for transact in online banking. Virtual keypad, you can see that. Okay, virtual is nothing but is an imaginary, not actually existing here, physically not existing. Imaginary it is there, but you can use those things also. Okay, so what is a virtual work? Virtual means imaginary. Work is nothing but, if I say mechanical work is nothing but when a body is changes position, means when it changes position, when until unless an external force is acting here, then work has to be done. Work is nothing but what? Force into displacement. That is a work, mechanical work. Now here virtual means imaginary. Work is nothing but what? Force into displacement. Suppose if imaginary work is done on the system, okay, if you consider each part of the body, if imaginary work is done, if you sum all those imaginary work, what is the total work done by the system is zero. That's the principle of virtual work states that. See that principle of virtual work, it states that the work done during a virtual displacement from the equilibrium is equal to zero. Means total work done by the system is zero. What is a virtual displacement means? It's an imaginary infinitesimal displacement on the system. You know, imaginary infinitesimal means very, very small amount of displacement, means change in position of a body takes place. When the body changes position, until unless an external force is acting on the body. When force is there and change in position of a body, then we can say the work is done by the system, right? Now there's a virtual displacement, nothing but imaginary infinitesimal displacement of the system. Now what is the difference here? Earlier, how do you analyze force analysis? By taking each part, we'll go for draw a diagram, isolated diagram from each part of the mechanism. That is a free body diagram. Then we'll go for analyze what is the work, what is the force is acting on each part of the mechanism by drawing free body diagram. But here, if you go for principle of virtual work, see that by applying this principle, an entire mechanism is examined as a whole, and there is no need of dividing into a free body diagram. Now you can see the consider this example, a slider crank mechanism. If you go for analysis this slider crank mechanism, what we'll do? We'll draw the free body diagram for each part, link 2, link 3, and link 4. Then what is the nature of forces acting on the each part? Then that is we draw a separate diagram. There is a free body diagram. So don't go for draw the free body diagram, and we'll go for consider entire mechanism as it is, consider entire whole a part or a whole mechanism consider. Then when external force is applied here, then how the body's forces are transmitted here? What is the input torque is required to make a system is balanced? That principle what we applied here, we are considering whole body in the principle of virtual work to determine the forces acting on the body, or what is the torque is required to make the system is equilibrium. That is the difference between principle of virtual work and what we analyzed in the previous methods. Okay, Now consider a slider crank mechanism as shown in the figure. It is acted upon by a external force F. F is acting where? Force is acting on the slider, right? F is acting on the slider. Is towards the body, towards the slider. External force is applied on the piston. Now external crank torque T and the forces at the bearings. Now due to here force is applied here. Now the slider undergoes a small infinitesimal displacement. What type of displacement here? Linear displacement. That is how much here? Delta X. Now we can say the work done by the slider is, what is the work is equal to what? Force into displacement, right? Force into displacement. This is the work done by the slider. At the same time, other work also done by the system. What is the other work here? At the bearing also an external force is there, but there is no displacement at the bearing. Means what is the work done at the joints B, A, O? Those are the turning pairs, right? We call it as a bearings also. Those are the bearings or the joints. There is no displacement here. That's why for only forces exist. Force is there, displacement is zero. Means work done is zero. It comes to a crank input link. Here see that once you apply force here F towards the slider moves from this direction to this. At the same time, the what happened? The crank is moved from A to, I'll call it, this is A1. It moves A to A1 in this angular displacement. How much angular displacement takes place here? Delta theta. Now what is the work done by the crank? Here instead of for linear, the linear displacement of body, work done is equal to force into displacement. For angular motion of the body, what is the work done is equal to? Work done is equal to torque into angular displacement, the T into delta theta. Now there are two work done by the system, by the slider crank mechanism you consider. One is work done by the slider, another one is work done by the what is that input link, a crank. What is the remaining work done also takes place here at the joints O, A, B, but there is no displacement here, that work done is zero. What is the total work done? Total work done here, work done at the slider plus work done at the crank, that is equal to total work done by the system, that is equal to zero, according to what? Principle of virtual work. The work done during the virtual displacement from the equilibrium is equal to zero, or total work done by the system is equal to zero. Again, here is a small derivation is there. Here is a small derivation. And also is an important one also for exam point of view. Now consider a slider crank mechanism. Now what are the forces and displacement acting on that body? You see that as the crank rotates through a small angular displacement delta theta, the corresponding displacement of the piston is delta X. Or if you take the slider moves delta X, the corresponding the crank moves delta theta. Okay. Now what are the various forces acting on the system? The first one is bearing reactions at O. Here is a bearing here. At reaction at O, this is a supporting element, this is a bearing element, this is a turning pair here it is, performs no work. Because work, when you say work is equal to force into displacement should be there. But here force is there, there is no displacement, change in position is not there. That's why work is no work. Second one is force on the cylinder, on the piston. What is the force on cylinder on the piston here? This is the piston. Okay, this is the piston. What is the cylinder? This is the cylinder. What is the force acting on the piston through the from the piston is vertical force here. Is there any vertical displacement of the slider? No. Force is there. There is no vertical displacement here. That is also, what is that? Second statement, force of cylinder on piston perpendicular to the piston displacement. The piston moves in what here? Linear motion, right? Linear motion. Perpendicular to the displacement, the produces no work. Again, force is there, but no displacement. There is no slider will not move in vertical direction. Again, work done is zero. Third one, the bearing forces at A, B. These are the turning pairs, right? This is also, O is also a turning pair. Is the bearing forces are zero because force is there, but there is no displacement. What is the remaining two are important here? Now, where is the work done by the system? Work done by torque, an external work done by torque on the crank. That is for the crank undergoes what type of motion here? Angular motion. This is the equilibrium here. The torque undergoes angular motion. Crank undergoes angular motion. That is work done by torque is equal to T into delta theta. Similarly, what is the one more work done here? Work done by external force, F is equal to WF is equal to force into displacement. These are the two work done by the system. These are total work done by the system is, remember these two work done. Next. Yeah, now according to the principle of virtual work, what is the total work done by the system is equal to zero. What are the work done by the system? One is work done due to a torque applied on the crank. Another one is work done due to an external force here. What is the force work done by due to a torque on the crank here? T into delta theta plus work done by force is equal to F into delta x, that is equal to zero. Now you go for apply, these are imaginary displacements. Now I'll go for differentiate with respect to time. As a virtual displacement must take place during the same interval of delta theta. If you consider small infinitesimal time, then you go for delta theta. Now will become this delta become now will become an exact differential term. Now consider only this part. Okay, consider only this part. Now if you differentiate with respect to time, if you take in time interval, differentiate equation one with respect to time. Now t delta t become d theta by dt plus f into delta x become dx by dt, that is equal to zero. Now what is d theta by tt? It's the angular motion. D theta means change in angular motion with respect to time. The rate of change of angular motion is called as what? Angular velocity. Second one, dx by dt. X is nothing but linear displacement. The change in linear displacement with respect to time. The rate of change of linear displacement, that is what we get, linear velocity. D theta by dt is equal to omega. There is angular velocity in radian per second. Dx by dt is equal to v. There is a linear velocity of the slider in meter per second, or linear velocity of the piston. Now substitute those values. Now what we'll get, t into omega plus f into v is equal to zero, called as equation number two. Now rearrange that term. Finally, what you'll get? What is the how much torque we required here? That is equal to F divided by W into, F divided by omega into V. Why the negative sign indicates? The negative sign indicates if you want to make it equilibrium, we force applied in this direction, displacement in the direction, whatever the four torque we're applying in opposite to that one. The negative sign indicates that the equilibrium of T must be applied in opposite direction of the angular displacement. The angular displacement in what direction? Due to an external force, in counterclockwise. But we need to apply a torque in what? Opposite to that. That's a negative sign shows. So remember this equation. Remember the derivation also. That is a very important one. What is the torque applied on the crank? T is equal to minus into F divided by omega into V. What is the unit of torque? Newton meter. Okay. Now this up to this. So keep in mind, up to this you study that. We study that three problems. So one problem on the, again, one more stator crank mechanism. Another one is the principle of virtual work. In next class, we'll go for consider friction in mechanism. Earlier, in previous classes, what is the statement you consider when I go for analysis of a four bar mechanism and a stator crank mechanism? What we consider here, neglecting friction at the joints, right? What are the joints here? A, B, C are from C and link 4 and link 1. This is a prismatic pair, sliding pair. There also we neglect the friction. We are neglecting the friction at the joints. But in next class, we'll go for consider a friction at the joint, friction in mechanism. Tomorrow we'll discuss these things. Okay. And also we solved one problem on this by considering friction in the mechanism. Then that completes one complete question. Okay, from exam point of view, we'll complete the one question. Second question is a dynamic force analysis. If you want to study the dynamic force analysis, we should know velocity and acceleration analysis of the mechanism. I think that you studied in your kinematics of machine. Yes, yes or no? Nikites? Nikites is there?
Yes, sir.
So you studied a velocity and acceleration analysis of the mechanism in kinematics of machine. Say yes or no, ma'am. If you know that,
no. Yes, sir.
You know the velocity and acceleration analysis of the mechanism in kinematics of machine in fourth semester. Have you studied that topic?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then if you study, then you go for solve the problem on that. Because if you know the velocity and acceleration analysis of the mechanism, again, four-bar mechanism, third-rank mechanism, then we'll go for analyze dynamics force analysis. Here, what we studied here up to static force analysis means the body at rest position or in continuous motion. Continuous motion means velocity is constant. Then I want to make it equilibrium. What are the forces acting on the body or parts of the mechanism that we studied? When it accelerated, the body is accelerated means velocity changes with respect to time. Then we should know the velocity diagram and acceleration diagram. Then we'll go for analyze the dynamic force analysis. Okay. So next class,
okay,
we'll go for friction in mechanism and we solve the problems on this. Next, we'll go for dynamic force analysis. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. If you have any doubt, now you can ask me the clarify your doubts. Yes. Now still we have 3 more minutes we have. Now if you have doubts, you can clarify it. At the same time, I'll take attendance. US number 4, Abhilash.
Okay. Fine, sir.
Okay, sir. 5 is also there. 6, Abhishek Reddy.
Present, sir.
9.
Present, sir.
9, Atar Saifula. US number 9. Not there. Next, US number 12, Bharat GM.
Present, sir.
US number 14, Bhargav Reddy. Yes, present.
13, sir.
Okay, 13 already you present, ma. Only I already taken the attendance. But any blank name, blanks is there, then only I call their name. Okay. US number 22. Saran Kumar, yes.
Sir, 14 present, sir. Hello.
Okay, ma, you are present. I'm asking only the absentees. Okay, US number 22, Charan Kumar, N. Not there. US number 28, Danush. US number 28. 30, Durga Prasad.
Present, sir.